So, can a computer solve any problem that meets these three requirements? And it seems, in a way, like a computer should be able to do that, doesn't it? I mean, the input is fit for a computer, the output is fit for a computer, we have even been very, very nitpicky with finite strings, constant number of symbols, and we want an objectively correct and definitive answer. No grading students' essays, no predicting the future, no looking at pictures and telling us if they're beautiful. I'm now going to show you a problem that meets these three criteria. I will also be able to show you that no computer can ever solve it. And this is actually a problem where it would be very useful to have a computer being able to solve it. So I guess you've all been in this situation here, where on your computer you're working, and you've just started a certain type of calculation or task on the computer. The computer tells you, yes, I'm 10% done. Then after a while, this moves to 20%. After a while, it moves to 30%. And of course, depending on what system you're working on, your mouse turns into this hourglass here. And now the progress bar gets stuck and it stays there. You go have lunch, you come back, and it stays there. So the question is, at some point in time, I mean, you want this task to get done, but maybe in the next minute, the computer will go on. Maybe it's just thinking, it's just working. But it could, of course, also be that your program has crashed. If your computer stays that way for quite a time, well, you probably would assume that it has crashed, but you never know for sure. So what if we had an algorithm for that? What if we had an algorithm that took as input a computer program P? It could be written in any language, basically. So Python, C++, Java, whatnot. And of course, we also wanted input for that program. And the input, of course, in accordance with rule number one, will be a finite string using a constant number of symbols. And actually, the program, of course, will be as well. So it may be, for example, the source code of a program. We want this algorithm to tell us, if we run the program on the input, does the computer ever finish? Or does it go into an infinite loop? Very simple question. And of course, this problem totally conforms with all three requirements here. So as I just said, the input is a finite string, constant number of symbols, perfect. Output, it's a decision problem. So the output will either be yes or no. And of course, the output is also objectively correct because we're talking about deterministic machines here. So you can easily check if the program indeed will go into an infinite loop if the computer tells you where the problem is. And this problem is known as the famous, and it's really famous, Halting problem.